you can see how successful the love life of performers is because we're here. But good to see you guys. I know all of you, so this isn't going to be our standard introduction, but obviously we have a bit of a light crowd tonight. A bit of a change from last week when we had like 500 people here for the open mic. Luckily, unfortunately, I know last week you got cut short, so this time you get some extra time. So, it's a give and a take. I'm glad you guys made it out. We can still have fun tonight, even though it's a little light. Just remember, be supportive of everybody. Clap it up. Get into the music. If people are playing music, when comedians come up, laugh like obnoxiously loud, like really annoyingly stupidly loud. Like that, yeah. And, make people feel welcome. You get it, you get out what you put into a show like this. That's the point. I've done many a bar show with two people in the audience, and one of which I drove with, so... we'll have a good time. We actually have some audience here. Welcome, ladies. Good to see you. Have you been to the open mic before? No? Oh, well, good. This will be a fun little experience for you. This is a show we do every Thursday night. We do it every Thursday of the year except Thanksgiving. So strap in. It is an open mic show, which basically means anybody can come up on stage and perform whatever talent they want to perform. We have musicians, comedians, sometimes we have poets. Who knows what else could happen? Well, I know because I know everybody here, but you never know what could happen in the night. It's a lot of fun. Definitely more interesting than anything you'd be at home watching on TV tonight, so strap in. The one thing that we do ask from the audience is just remember everybody that you're seeing perform tonight, they're here performing for free. So be respectful, be supportive. Keep your table talk down while you're in the showroom. If you do have to talk louder, you can go into the lounge area right across the hall. But while you're in here, just try to pay attention. Clap when people get on and off stage. And be nice, be supportive. Every big star that you see on TV or you hear on the radio, they started someplace like this. And the reason that they went from someplace like this to the big time is because they had support along the way. And we like to try to give that same feeling of support to everybody that gets on stage here. Remember, if you enjoy yourself tonight, and even if you don't, follow the Brew House on all social media platforms that are everywhere. Facebook, Instagram, MySpace, maybe. I don't know. All the social media, that's how you keep in touch with everything that's happening here and at the Kelsey Theater next door. They have a lot of great shows there. They have a lot of different events all throughout the week here. Also, I wanted to mention, Royce has been kind enough, you may have noticed he's been videotaping most of the open mics, I think actually all of them. and he does post them on the Brew House website. He puts them in the post section, not in the video section. So if you come out to a show and you want to see a video of yourself on stage, head on over to the Brew House website. You can look it up because thanks to our kindly videographer, that is available for you. And what else do I like to mention in the announcements? Try the beers. They're awesome. The more beer you have, the more entertaining entertainment is. That's just true. Yeast and barley and hops make things good. They do have food available at the bar. You can order right from the bar. They hand you a little number card. They deliver it right to your table. It's from the restaurant down on the corner. It's very good food. The only thing to remember is the server who brings you your food, if you order from the bar, they don't get tipped out from the bar because they work for the restaurant down the corner. So if you do order food and you have somebody bringing your food, give them something of a tip because it's always nice to get paid for what you do. And beyond that, just strap in. We are a light audience tonight, but we can be a strong audience together. That's what I like to think. And yeah, we'll have some fun. Obviously, we are light tonight, so typically the rules for the Brew House, performer-wise, musicians typically get two songs. Comics, poets, spoken word get 5 minutes. But we're really light tonight, so I'm going to give everybody some extra time. that could possibly change if like a busload of performers comes in the next couple minutes. But you can plan on 3 songs for musicians and 7 minutes for spoken word. If that does change in any way, I will let you know before you go up. And yeah, let's just give a round of applause. We're gonna have some fun tonight.
Yay!
Now, my name is John Hine. I am your guest host for the evening. I'm filling in for your regular host, Wayne Felber, who is recovering from a medical procedure that he had to go through. Myself and my co-host, Rachel, are going to be filling in tonight and the next couple shows until he gets back on his feet and is back out here. But beyond hosting the show, I am a stand-up comic, so I'm going to do a few jokes, and then we'll get into other performers. Trying to think of some things new or that I've been working on lately. The Super Bowl was recently. Don't know if you guys saw that, but almost everybody did. So, you know, it's the biggest TV event of the year. But this year, I think the Super Bowl was boring, I think is the best word to describe it this year. Boring, I think that's it. I was definitely much more interested in the Puppy Bowl. Like, I was way more entertained by that. You know, a lot of people say that the NFL and the Super Bowl is fixed. I think the Puppy Bowl was fixed. Or at least a lot of the players were. That joke was brought to you by Bob Barker. I've been thinking a lot about pets lately. I just got a new pet. He's sitting right there. He's a cute little guy. But there are all sorts of different pets people can have. But really, there are only 2 like main pets. It's cats and dogs. And people argue back and forth like which is better. You know, a cat's better or a dog's better. I am definitely in the camp that dogs are better. Mainly because nobody has ever made a movie about people being sad that their cat died. Like, there are hundreds of movies where people cry about the dog dying, but nobody cares if the cat dies. Like, that's not true. I like cats too. Cats are fine animals. I've never had a cat, but they're fine. I just think dogs are cooler. You know, dogs are, they're the party animal. They're the animal that wants, that plays poker. The animal that runs around everywhere with you. Like, if you have a party, you would never want to have a cat there. Like, that's... Like, okay, well, you might invite a cat to your party, but a cat would never show up to your party. Like, that's... you know, cats are dicks. And then, you know, then you get into the weirder pets, like, fish, like... I don't even think fish count as pets, like a lot of people say. My apartment complex actually has a rule, technically, they spell out in the bylaws that you're only allowed to have 1 pet, including fish. That's written in the bylaws of the apartment complex, including fish. Like somebody's going to come in and count the fish in your fucking fish tank. Oh, I'm sorry, I shouldn't swear. That was my bad, people. I have to put $1 in the swear jar. Yes, side note, don't do that. No, this is supposed to be a PG-13 show. We don't allow like swearing and stuff, so I apologize. But yeah, anyway, fish. And I think that's like a ridiculous law because fish aren't pets. Like, fish are decorations that can die. Like, that's all fish really are. They just swim around. Like, a fish is never happy to see you. The fish doesn't care. It just swims. Anyway, I like to travel a lot. My girlfriend and I, we like to travel. We recently went up to the Blue Ridge Parkway. I don't know if anybody's been there, but if you haven't, it's a beautiful trip. You should definitely go. It's basically this big highway that goes all through the Appalachian Mountains, and it's gorgeous. It's very serene, very peaceful. You should definitely make it a goal to be on that at some point. But it's kind of interesting because, like, geographically, Florida is southern, but culturally, we're not that southern. And then you get somewhere like Tennessee, where the trail starts, and you're instantly in the true South, you know. And the differences are apparent right away. Like, everything there is deep fried. The meat is deep fried. The vegetables are deep fried. The books are deep fried. Like, everything is deep fried. Really haven't had a Grisham until you've had it deep fried, let me tell you. But the other thing that the South has that you don't find too much here, all these independent hotel and motels, like there are thousands of them on the side of the highway and all these like $39.95 a night places. And they all try to offer something to stand out from the other ones. You know, they'll have like a free water slide or breakfast included or something like that. But some of them I think are trying too hard. Like we passed one, I swear to God, the sign said $39.95 a night, utilities included. Like, how crummy is your hotel where utilities aren't included, you know? Could you imagine checking in there, like, here's your room key, and here's the number for the power company. Oh, did you think utilities were included? No, we're just an 8 motel. Have utilities included, you'd have to find some kind of like super 8 motel. I don't know. We drive around a lot. Driving around Florida recently, we passed what I think was the most Florida billboard possible. It was a billboard advertising a hospital that specialized in treating stroke victims. And there was a patient testimonial on the sign. And the quote on the billboard was, "Thanks to my stroke care team, I'm back on the shooting range." Is that really what we want to encourage? Like, have you had a stroke? That's no reason to stop shooting things. Come to our hospital. I don't know. What else do I want to talk to you guys about? I'll go ahead and wrap up with one more. I just want to think of what I want to finish on, something I haven't done in a while here. I'll do this one. This is a joke I say for special occasions, just like tonight. It's actually the first joke I ever wrote. I was 6 years old when I wrote this joke. And if you guys don't laugh at this one, I'm just going to stay on stage. So, yeah. Do your best. What do you get when you cross a duck with gunpowder? Fire quackers! All right, folks. You ready to keep this show rolling? All right. Brewhouse, let's get excited for your next performer coming to stage. Start clapping it up for Drew, everybody.
Gotta be considerate. How are we doing tonight, Brewhouse? I've noticed I am dressed very well for the state in which I live in. But I like it. And yes, I am single. Today is Valentine's Day. And no, I am not available, ladies, so please don't try. I thought that one would have went over a little bit better, but it's okay. Today is Valentine's Day, is it not?
Yes.
Nada. Got a great audience there and an even better one out there. There we go. Last week, you had the pleasure, if you were here, of me making jokes about my autism spectrum disorder. Today, not so much. I don't know. I 3 years ago, at the end of next month, I met the most amazing woman I've ever seen. I could very well be wrong, but I might not be. And she, you know, it motivated me to find a job and, you know, get my ass out of bed at a reasonable hour. I wake up at 6 a.m. every day, you know, get on my socks and stuff and go to work, which has been great. I work with kids. Had no idea that I would love working with kids, but I do. And yesterday, with my fourth graders, of which I was working with, we sewed some hearts together, and we're sending them down to the students and staff down in Parkland. So if it wasn't for her, I probably would, you know, not be at an amazing job. So anyway, should probably let her know that the next time that I see her. Hopefully she won't get terribly freaked out by that, because we don't even know each other's last names. But still, it's very, very, very sweet. And humans get motivated by very, very, very strange things. Anybody knows the term that love is blind and irrational? It is. Damn it. There we go. You know, I thought about bringing my photograph here tonight and lip-syncing Calendar Girl, but I decided not to. Kind of wish I would have, but it's cool. So, you know what? Let's try to finish up last week's list of stuff. And by the way, people who say, you know, you're socially awkward, you have ASD, you're absolutely correct. I'm very socially awkward. Sometimes my students ask me, Mr. Drew, and I say yes. Is there a reason why you involuntarily roll your eyes back into your head when you talk like the Undertaker? Because I used to work at the Haunted Mansion, and I used to tell people to go into that room. Why do most people, how long does an ASPE last in the room? Well, that depends on the resource depletion. Might last the whole day, but very unlikely. Why does the person flap his hands like crazy? It's because he's autistic. When I came up here last week, I came up, you know, like this, and that's something I've not done in a long time. People say, I've never would have thought that you had it, Drew, unless you would have told me. When I was in college, my roommate who won a Super Bowl playing for the Patriots, God, him and I smoked a lot of weed every single day for a year. And when people say, you know, weed helps autistic people, I'd say that that's a prime example of me being a prime example. But I don't know, maybe I matured and grew as a person too in that time, but I don't know. I would not recommend you giving your kids weed if you have autistic kids, because they might not respond to it well. There were times when I was doing it where I was scared I wasn't going to come down, and I said, guys, I'm driving myself to the hospital, and they had to take my keys away from my crazy ass. Also, unfortunately, a true story. How many autistics do you need to change the light bulb? One. Any more than that will fail because of awkward. Who are the real nerd gamer girls? Asper girls. Why is that person talking to you scary? He may gossip or attack, and you would never know. What are social rules? I think it's undefined behavior, as quoted by the programmer Autist. What makes an autistic happy? Having a normal day. Burger. Let's give Indy a hand. Thank you, Indy.
There you go, Indy.
Dun da dun da dun da da. He's perfectly fine. You guys know people that have this disorder? We have a tendency to have incredible rote memorization, and I'll give you a couple of examples. When I met this girl 3 years ago, we shook hands. Probably the reason why I haven't washed my right hand in over 3 years, but that's good. And she had on a blue denim shirt and black denim jeans and gold sandals, and it was about noon, maybe 11:30, on the 30th of March of 2016. I'm also, unfortunately, a Miami Dolphins fan. And my memories of the team are extraordinarily ridiculous. My first Dolphins game I ever went to was September 20th of 1992. It was a Sunday, a 4 p.m. kickoff. It was still 93 degrees at kickoff time. It was hot. The game was blacked out on TV. And they made it to the AFC Championship game that year, which kind of tells you how fraudulent our fans are down here anyway, but still. And the Dolphins had on white jerseys and aqua pants, and they won the game 26-10. Later on in that season, I was at a playoff game against the Chargers, where the Dolphins won 31-0 in the rain and advanced to the AFC Championship game. The following week, is that my light? Okay. The following week, the Dolphins would lose to the Bills at home 29-10. Wearing white jerseys and aqua pants, Jenga. Mark Duper. That would be January 17th of 1993, the game of which I'm currently telling you about. Not that that's very relevant, but, Mark Duper had a 27-yard touchdown catch, and I told him that when he saw me at the Dolphins-Jags game, and he said, I've seen you perform your comedy before, and you're funny. And I said, yeah, well, it depends. You guys have a good evening, and happy Valentine's Day.
One more time for Drew, everybody. Clap it up for him. You know, Drew, if you haven't washed your hand in 3 years, that might be why you got a cold. Like, I don't... just a thought. All right, ladies and gents, we're going to keep this show rolling. Your next guy coming to stage, he's very funny. I want you to clap it up for Mr. Matt Durndeck, everybody. Clap it up for him.
Drew's ex-girlfriend, guys. I'm the one that, my last name's Durndeck. I feel like now's the time I should finally tell you, you know? I was sitting back there kind of in the dark, and I was like, what are the chances that this is when we finally reconnect? I didn't want you to work with kids, though. I just wanted you to get up early and get the hell out, you know? That's mainly what it was about. I want you to work with kids. I've been kind of sad lately. My cat died. It's just so sad. What's sadder than that? Can you think of anything? Can you think of a single thing more sad than a domesticated animal that doesn't want to be domesticated dying? I can't. I'm excited for after this, though, because I'm going to go home to my pet fish. She's always happy to see me. You know, it's just always, every time, he's like... You know, he goes in the rock and comes out real fast. Also, because I have leftovers of fried pelican brief. Fried pelican brief. That's a John Grisham book, I think, right? Isn't it? Yeah.
Probably.
I'm ashamed to admit, when I was a teenager, I read all the John Grisham, and I thought I was, like, being grown up. Should have read, like, Dickens or something, you know? Trying out this new look. It's a new look. It's kind of a, you know, I teach, the look is, during the day I teach high school econ, and at night I coach co-ed softball. Thank you. And then I got fired, and I was like, well, I'll try stand-up for the first time. That's the look. It's a pretty complete look. Hello, welcome. I don't know if there's any seats left, actually. I don't, you guys might have to stand. Yeah, I don't, yeah. Oh no, those are just kidding, okay. JK. It's good in comedy when you say just kidding. You wanna say that as much as possible. Take that from a guy who's doing it for the first time. November 8th, 2016, right? The night we all thought that, you know, there'd be the first female president. But instead, how are we gonna remember it? We're gonna remember it as the night that Janet Reno died. That's right, that's how we're all gonna, it gets overlooked. Miss Janet, old Janie. She was great at whatever she did for Clinton. I don't know, secretary of something or other. Some kind of cabinet member. All right. She burned down Texas or something. I don't know what she did. I'm just trying to get over it. You know, Brian, I'm trying to. Does your shirt say crazy cat?
Gentleman.
Oh, the twist at the end there. That's how comedy works. That was good. I had an MRI last week. I had a brain tumor a long time ago. And, you know, it's fine now, but I get these regular tumors. And I was asked the neurosurgeon, like, can I stop? Like, can I spread out the MRIs? You know, so I don't have to, like, think about it. And he's like, no, you must always think about your brain tumor coming back. I was like, well, that's a way to live, I guess. Can I just have it back? I'd rather just have it. And then I could be like plan to get it out, like rather than just being fearful of a new one. Can you put the old one back? And then we can, cause it was like, you just interview surgeons and prepare to die, you know? That's better. This look is also like, I feel like if I had sunglasses, it's a good, like, just committed a crime. And because I was washing my hands, I was like, this hat is too, like, generic. I mean, you know? Your hat has character. Mine is like, I'm in a disguise. Anyway, so I murdered this guy last night, and it was not one of my better ones. Yeah, good. I don't really watch a lot. If you could keep doing that, you could keep. No, it adds to the. I sing actually at the end of my sets, and that's that when I ask for it, you know, people ask for like a note or, you know, sing, like, can I have a whatever? I ask for, can someone drag a wooden chair on the tile? Hello, welcome. Come on in. If you can find a seat, you can have it, but I already told that joke. It's getting old. Is it hack if you retell your own joke kind of a little bit differently? It's still hack, right? That's just like, no, it's not? All right. Brian, don't you dare look at your notes before, don't do exactly what I do before I go up. Look at them. No, you can look at them now. It'd make me more comfortable, actually. Have you lit me? I feel like I'm running.
I'm lighting you now.
Thank you. And there's a, you know, you want to get to the point in comedy where you're like, I hope this is over soon, you know? That's, and by that I mean life, you know? I'm just glad I got that fish at home. It'd be way better if old Kitty was still alive, you know? That's right. I redid three jokes now of my own. I could I could watch football for days when I was a kid, but I don't really watch it anymore. But my new hobby is I call Drew and just have him recite Dolphins games to me, actually. Yeah, it's kind of like they used to have like phone sex lines you could call. Now I just call and I press whatever Mark Duper's number is, his old 80 something.
85.
85, so close. And then Drew picks up and he's like, May 1998. The Bills going to their fifth Super Bowl. All right. Guys, this has been fantastic. This is actually my Netflix special is what Royce is really filming. Thank you. Have a good night.
One more time for Matt, everybody. Clap it up for him. And the audience keeps building. This is great. By next week, we'll have a crowd. Like, this is good. All right, folks. We're going to keep things moving right along here. Your next performer coming to stage, he's also very funny. I want you to clap it up for Mr. Brian Manning, everybody. Clap it up for him.
Good evening, good evening. How's everyone doing? Great to be back at the Brew House. I haven't been here for a couple weeks. I was out visiting family back home. I'm from Massachusetts. And when I say I'm from Massachusetts, everybody usually assumes Boston. But no, I'm from outside Boston. And it's good to be outside of Boston. Anybody who's from Boston is like, oh yeah, I need everybody to know I'm from Boston. And I need to know everyone who's not from Boston so I can hate them. Yeah, but before I went to Massachusetts, I had to stop in Chicago 2 weeks ago, and it was record-breaking cold. It was negative 51 degrees outside, and you know it's cold when they give you the temperature and they don't even say what the temperature scale is. When it's negative 51, nobody's going outside for that. And yeah, like, some people in Chicago were saying, oh, it's so cold that you gotta get that cup of boiling water and then throw it over your head so it instantly freezes. And I go, are you mad? Do you think I would spare with such a treasure of warm water like that? No, I'm waiting 10 minutes and pouring it on my body. But, heat is weird like that, especially some of these temperature scales. Like, you have Celsius out there, and that one makes sense, that 0, water freezes, 100, water boils. Makes sense. But what's going on with Fahrenheit? With Fahrenheit, water freezes at 32, and water does, like, boils at 212 or something. What's left for that 0 and 100 spot? Well, the 0 spot on the Fahrenheit scale, that's the temperature at which ocean water freezes, 0 degrees Fahrenheit. But what's 100 degrees Fahrenheit? That's the internal temperature of a cow. When they were designing universal constants, this guy was like, a cow's internal temperature is always 100 degrees. Oh yeah, yeah. Fun fact. And when I was at the airport and I called up an Uber and I was like trying to go someplace north, and I'm just gonna use like some local references, say I landed at PBI and I'm like, oh, I'm trying to go to Stewart. And the Uber driver is like, oh, well, I'm not trying to go to Stewart, I'm trying to go to Boca. And it's like, what's going on with that? What kind of app are you using? I'm using the app in which I tell people where to take me. Are you trying to use the app where you get to decide where to go? I don't think that app is called Uber. Yeah. Oh, geez. Valentine's Day, I thought I would start my open mic around strangers, and then I would leave with around loved ones. And I just mean because I broke a five at the bar and they gave me back some singles and they felt like very heavily loved ones. Where have these things been? I mean, one was wet, I had to wring it out. Jeez, George Washington, like, where have you, like, what are you doing? The bill says in God we trust. Where else have you been? But, yeah, another thing, I love audiobooks and I was checking out my Audible app on my phone. They have all these user stats on there. Like total listening time, and I have a total usage time of these audiobooks of 6 months. That's so long. That's longer than some of my relationships. And that's kind of surprising because I'm obviously such a good listener. I'm like listening to the audiobooks, it's like the girlfriend's crying, it's like quiet, I'm trying to learn about women from Venus. Yeah, did anybody see that Amazon is no longer building a second headquarters in New York? This is brand new news. And wow, this is the biggest, hey, where did my Amazon package kind of thing ever? I mean, all these New Yorkers are like, where'd my Amazon package go? Jeez, poof. Drew's performing tonight. I can imagine that he's dressed up in his suit. When they saw that he put his name on the list, they were like, who is this guy? Dr. Ooh? Dr. Ooh? Yeah, when I was trying to go to school, I was trying to determine what major to do. I had to choose between engineering or psychology. Like, kind of different roads. And, you know, I decided to, like, put both kind of thought processes to it. Like my engineer mind cranked the numbers and like did it out and realized, you know, I probably would make more money as an engineer than as a psychologist. And then the psychologist part of me thought about it and realized, you know, I really wouldn't be successful as a psychologist because you can't be crazier than all your patients. You're like with them and they're like, Jesus Christ, is there an adult we can get in this room? Yeah. Did anybody see the Super Bowl? Yeah. What a surprise this Patriots win. Man, I hate reruns. Can't they write anything now? Yeah, that joke was bad, but at least it wasn't as bad as the Super Bowl. I mean, at least that joke didn't have Adam Levine's nipples in it until now. My manager at work told me, that I'm overactive with my pun references and it needs addressing. Yikes. I asked him, which one? Ranch, Italian, Thousand Island, vinaigrette? Which addressing do we need? Dating is difficult these days, just the way technology is kind of set up. You have some of these apps out there. And I feel like sometimes people are using these apps almost as if they're looking for some late night food. They're just going through the menus. They're like, not this, I'm hungry, but not that hungry. And like, we're just all trying to satisfy our bodily urges. But this Tinder food delivery game, I mean, it's probably so different for if you're a woman out there. That you're probably scanning this Tinder app and like imagining all these guys are restaurants. And it's like, Jesus Christ, they'll deliver anywhere. Like this guy, he's delivering right now. Yeah. I mean, like they're going through these apps and they go, geez, everything is open. Everything will deliver to me. And yeah, I mean, you don't have to worry about pickup. They'll deliver it to you. You may ask, do I have to tip them? And don't worry, they'll tip you. Yeah. I'll just close with this last awful one. I went to the barber the other day and they were cutting my hair and it was just about done and then they were like, oh yeah, we need to get your eyebrows. And I'm like, what, my eyebrows? Like, are they that long? Do we need to cut my eyebrows? And they go, yeah, it's real easy. We can just take a comb and run the clippers across. And I'm like, I didn't ask how you're going to do it. I'm asking about the eyebrow. Tell me about the eyebrow. I mean, can't we remember rule number one? Browse before the house, people. Browse before the house. Anyways, that's my time. Thank you very much, Pucci.
One more time for Brian, everybody. Clap it up for him. All right, ladies and gents, coming up next, we have my partner in crime here, and she's bringing our newest furry friend with her. I want you to clap it up for Rachel, everybody. Rachel Blavatnik coming to stage.
Hi, everybody. They say never follow animals, so. Honestly, I've really only written one joke this week, which is, who's a good boy? Who's a good boy? He's part Chihuahua and part Terrier. Chihuahuas are Mexican in origin. Terriers tend to burrow under things, so we're using him as a consultant for the wall. Did you hear it's going to be higher than Mount Everest? That's what he said. You'll have to be easier to climb Mount. How high is this wall? We're gonna have like air traffic trouble now. I was like, well, we can still fly to Cancun. No, you can't. Oh God, what is happening? Happy Valentine's Day.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Yeah. Oh yeah. We were talking the other day about. It's actually yesterday was the anniversary of me breaking up with my college boyfriend. Yeah, I broke up with him the day before Valentine's Day. I'm that one in that story. But to be fair, we weren't a great match. This was in the 90s, and do you remember that song, Whoomp, There It Is?
Yes.
That was his favorite song. That is not your favorite song! I'm a theater person. I'm into, like, Sondheim and Gershwin, and I can't date Whoomp, There It Is. Didn't work. Anyway. Oh, what else is happening in the world? It's been an interesting year so far. Had some stresses. Last month, I was 2 weeks late. Yeah. And at my age, you kind of have to worry. Pregnant? Or just old? Do you realize if I had a kid right now, when that kid was born, he would be 7 years old. We'd be shaving our beards at about the same time. It'd be bad. Be looking for a retirement home that had a good daycare plan. It'd be great. Oh, and everything political's bad. I mean, going back to this wall, I don't know if you've seen like one of his new plans is to get sponsorships for the wall. Royal Caribbean has jumped in. They're going to build one of those rock climbing walls instead. So if you get to the top and ring the bell, you get asylum. And a t-shirt. And if you pay a little bit extra, you can zip line right into Texas. It's going to be great. Oh, gosh. So quiet. I hate to bother you. I'm not even getting heckled by my dog. Oh gosh, what else? Been following a lot of news. I don't know if you've heard, but the state of Vermont is having trouble getting more of a population. They don't really have enough people, enough representation in government. So they are offering people $10,000 if you are willing to move to the state of Vermont. Yeah, the state of Vermont, kind of a slow state. Their motto is, we're just like Canada, without the health care. I'll wait. The state animal is a bear taking a nap. And the official sport of the state of Vermont is cross-country skiing out of Vermont. No one's paying anyone to live in New Hampshire, I'm just saying. Oh, gosh. It's been a better year, though, than last year. I spent most of last year unemployed. I did. I loved being unemployed. Do you guys have any idea how many times the Golden Girls are on in a day? It's awesome. I was teaching for a little while last year at a mental institution masked as a Palm Beach County Middle School. Yeah, I mean, these kids were dumb. I asked the girl what 6 times 7 was. She said Abraham Lincoln. I was teaching English, and part of my job was to teach figurative language. You know, what the difference is between a metaphor and a simile, for example. Metaphor and a simile. These kids didn't know what the letter J was. I found out on like my first week, they told me, I was teaching 6th grade, and they told me that a bunch of these kids had actually skipped 5th grade. And I was like, oh my God, super smart kids, yes. And it turned out, no, they were in 6th grade because they'd gotten too old to be in 4th grade. You should not be registering for AARP in elementary school. These kids were shaving like I'm gonna be in a couple, anyway. All right. Oh, I hate when the Jengas fall. It's so sad. All right, I'm gonna be getting out of here in a second because, heck, why not? It's comfortable over there and I got a puppy, so you know, I'm one up on everyone. Except John right now. All right, yeah, it has been. It's been interesting this whole year. I don't know where else to go with this. Oh, I know. I've been fighting some illnesses along the way. I had to stop actually on the way here. We had to stop at a pharmacy, pick up a prescription. And we went to the drive-through pharmacy. Who thought this was a good idea? To have your most personal, intimate medical information blared over a PA system? Just put this on the infected area twice a day until that rash clears right up. And do you want fries with that? And it was even more embarrassing because I was in an Uber. All right, that's enough. Thank you so much, Brew House. Let's hear it for Indy, who's making his way to the stage once more.
One more time for Rachel, everybody. Clap it up for her. All right, ladies and gents. We're actually about halfway through the show tonight. Are you having fun so far? Woo! All right, folks. We're going to keep things moving right along here with your next guy coming to stage. It's more comedy for you, more laughs per minute tonight than any other show around. I want you to clap it up for the very funny Mr. Roy Assembly, everybody. Clap it up for him.
If you've been here before, you know I talk about being old. I discovered I was old when I threw away my alarm clock instead of letting my bladder wake me up every morning at 6 o'clock. And then I realized that I was not sleeping with my teeth. I'm at an age where I only eat organic food because I need all the preservatives I can get. Now, I hope you don't mind, my memory's going, so I have to read my jokes. My body is falling apart, and what does not hurt does not work. My memory's failing, and I'm absent-minded, according to my wife. My hearing is going, at least the ear that my wife talks into. And I have no memory, so I can't, I'm getting close to 80, and I still think I'm 40. But this past week, my health insurance company sent a visiting nurse, as they do each year, to check me out. And when she got her stethoscope out to check my heart, I was hoping she wasn't deaf like me, or otherwise she might say I'm dead. Well, then she got out her, she wanted a urine sample, and I asked why, and she said it was to check to see if there was any blood in the urine. I said, if I had blood in the thing, I'd be using it. She even had me walk in a straight line, forward and backwards. Thank God she did not notice my shoes had training wheels on them. Then she wanted to give me a memory test. So I gave her my welcome. My name is Royce. I'm also known as Royce by choice, but that's because I talk in rhyme. I seem to do it all the time, and I feel fine, but everyone else seems to think it's a crime. My Afro-American friends think I'm talking rap, but I've told them that's a bunch of crap. They say if you talk in rhyme, then you're a sap, and I've tried to explain, look, I'm just an English chap who loves to rhyme when I get the chance. Since me body no longer lets me dance, words choke and fog my mind from knowing time. Then I start talking to everyone in rhyme. Some of my friends think I sound like Dr. Seuss, but I swear I don't like green eggs, ham, or juice. I'm just a simpleton who thinks with his heart, hoping my words will make me sound smart. Not schooled to write in proper verse, spelling and grammar, well, they've been my life's curse. But on I go looking for the truth, yet all I'm sure of is I've lost my youth. Well, I'm very happy that you're here, drinking all the brew house beer, but you better order another beer. I may end up sounding rather queer. Anyhow, I passed the test, and she gave me a clean bill of health. Now, an old friend of mine, he just got fitted for hearing aids, and he told me this. He said, I'm hearing better than I had in a decade. He said, I came back to the clinic and the audiologist asked him, how are those hearing aids doing? He says, I think they're doing great. I didn't tell my family. And he says, I've had to change my will 3 times this week. A blonde walks up to a deaf woman and starts talking. After a while, watching the woman signing with her hands, the blonde says, so sorry, I will get back to you when your manicure is dry. I planted him. My buddy said that he got a new hearing aids and with best money he can buy, and it's the state of the art. I asked, what kind is it? He replied, 11:15. What did the deaf guy say to the cop who pulled him over on I-95? You have the opportunity to remain silent. A man attends church at a prayer meeting, and the pastor asks if anyone has a prayer request. The man states, please pray for my hearing. So the pastor leads the congregation in a prayer for hearing, and after it was all over, as they were leaving, the pastor walks up to him and says, how does it feel? Any different about your hearing? Said the man said, I don't know. It's not until next Wednesday at the courthouse. What do UFOs and smart blondes have in camp common? You hear about them, but you never see them. Well, that one I might keep. A friend of mine had his credit card stolen. He, however, decided not to report it because the thief was spending less than his wife was. A man and his ever-nagging wife went on vacation in Jerusalem. While they were there, the wife passed away, and the undertaker told the husband, you can have her shipped home for $5,000, or you can bury her here in the Holy Land for $150,000. The man thought about it. He said, well, I think I'm going to have her shipped home. The undertaker said, why would you spend $5,000 to have her shipped home when she could be this wonderful buried in the Holy Land for $150,000? The man replied, long ago a man died here, was buried here, and 3 days later he rose from the dead. I just can't take the chance. They're old jokes. I dug them out of my file to come here tonight. A friend I know was sitting at a bar downing shots and whiskey, and I happened to come in and I see him, and I was shocked. I said, what are you doing? I've known you for over 15 years, and I've never seen you take a drink like this before. What's going on? Without even taking his eyes off his shot glass, he replied, "My wife just ran off with my best friend." I said, "But I'm your best friend." He looked at me, he said, "Not anymore, he is." The husband says to his wife, "You know what I just got in the mail? I got my Olympic condoms. They've arrived, and I think tonight I'll wear gold." His wife says, "Why don't you wear silver and come second for a change?"
Damn.
He's flashing the light at me, so I'll turn it over to the next comedian. Good night.
One more time for Royce, everybody. Clap it up for him. All right, your next performer coming to stage. I have actually not seen him before, so let's make him feel at home. I'm not sure if he's been here before or not, but either way, let's make him feel welcome and clap it up for Elijah Jaramillo, everybody. Clap it up for him.
How am I gonna follow that? Hi, how you doing, everybody? My first time doing stand-up at an open mic. It's really nice to be here. I like how everyone is grouped in twos. Two. And I like how the loudest audience has been a puppy this entire open mic night. But that's good, man. People like to choose animals over people. It's weird. Like, whenever a puppy, or not a cat, but if a puppy dies at a movie, you know, people cry. Like, people legit cry. But a human dies, they have to build like an entire 2-hour backstory in order for you to like at least frown in a movie. I really like the movies. But there's nothing good anymore. You've seen like the new trailers coming out right now? Like Pet Sematary? That old movie is getting remade now. But in 2019, like people are only gonna see that movie for the special effects. It's not like the story. The story wasn't really that good in Pet Sematary. If you haven't seen it or read it, it's basically pets die and you know, they come back to life. That's basically the whole thing. And, you know, you can't really build the story, like, on that alone. Like, I know it's, like, sad, but the whole point of it is it's built around humans, like, trying to save the animals and put their soul to rest. How do you do that? How do you put a puppy's soul to rest? Like, throw a tennis ball? Like, it's not gonna catch it. It's gonna go right through it. Feed it a bone? Can't do that. I live in Boca Raton. I don't know why I'm here. It's a long drive. a lot of old people in Boca Raton. Not to point out Royce. old people are like gangs over there. It's weird. It's like, you know, they own the streets in Boca Raton. It's all about who you know. A couple old ladies in their scooter. They have scooter gangs over there, just in the sidewalk. All single file, because you can't fit two scooters on the side. Ooh, but yeah, man. Boca Raton's very safe. It's like this room. It's a very safe room. I really feel like no hostility, really. But, you know, that could get boring after a while. Like a safe room. Like you want that sense of danger, you know, a little bit. You know, because, you know why people skydive and like, you know, like play rock, paper, scissors with a snake? something. You know, they like that sense of danger. Like, people don't like safety. And I feel like with the times now and the media and politics and all that stuff, it's all about making people feel safe inside. Like, people just want to feel safe. And, you know, I don't like feeling safe, really. Like, I'd rather choose, like, excitement over safety. You know, kind of like this Mickey Mouse picture right here. Mickey Mouse feels very safe, but he looks like he's in Harlem. But, what's it going on? Big news, man. Did you hear about the Amazon CEO that got a divorce? $700 billion in divorce settlements. It's nuts, man. It really is nuts. $700 billion. Just think of what you could do with that. You know. I know what I would do. And it's not... it's not good. It's not good. Like, you know, you find out who you truly are once you have money. And I know for a fact I'm a scumbag. Like, I know that, and I'm supposed to be poor. Like, I know that in life. I should not have any money or power whatsoever. I shouldn't be up on this stage right now. But, so what I would do with $700 billion, thank you for asking, I would get a lot of drugs. Drugs would be the first thing. Hideout would be the second thing. And just the third thing, you know, food, obviously. Food. I'll get a couple of cheese sticks. And then the last thing, just prostitutes. I'll just get them, like, hour on the hour. I'll hire every prostitute in America. If I had $700 billion, why would I just settle with one? a lot of weird stuff, man. And I don't like the that whole divorce settlements things either. It's really weird, man. Because it's like, you know, I people always said, like, the woman gets half. That was always the thing. Like, oh, you get a divorce, you get half of their stuff. New statistic, if I could say the word, statistic, it's apparently 80%. It's gone up. You get 80% of their stuff. That's depending on what you do. This dude right here, the Amazon guy, he cheated on his woman. Like, I don't get that. I don't get how you get $700 billion just for cheating. Like, that's it. The relationship should be over right then and there, but she'd feel like she could take 80% of this dude's fortune. I guarantee you, she doesn't even have a notebook of ideas or anything. Do you ever think, like, she just wrote down a business plan ever? This guy created Amazon. The biggest delivery service. And this woman is walking away $700 billion, man. Dang. That's why it's kind of hard to be a guy now. It's a little bit. I would much rather be a woman, especially now in 2019. It's nuts, man. Because, let's just admit it, the women have the power. Right, ladies? The women have the power now. Yeah. Nothing? Huh? I'm just out here. I'm not trying to make statements either. God, I'm in politics right now, apparently. I would much rather be a woman now. Because, that stereotypical guy thing. What if you were a girl? They'll be like, go, we'll give everybody, you know, sex. Stuff like that. That's always, like, the first thing. But, I wouldn't do that. I would do the exact same thing. Like, I would just hold out. I'd be like, oh, you know, I like that Cheesecake Factory. Ooh, I like that. And they'll take me out to Cheesecake Factory, and I'll be like, all right, that's it. Just drop me off home. Oh, but are we going to do anything later? I was like, yeah, later. Yeah, text me. And then I'll just go home. That's it. That'll be my my plan. As a girl. It's not a quest for power, really. I'll just do it for free food. That's all I'll do it for. Well, I guess I'll end on a laugh right there. Thank you guys so much. I appreciate it.
One more time for Elijah, everybody. Clap it up for him. First time doing stand-up. Not bad, man. Not bad. Takes a lot of guts to get up here for the first time, no matter what your talent is. It's hard to be on stage. They actually have done a lot of surveys. They say that public performance and public speaking, people fear that more than death. So, you know, now we can all die tonight, and we've been good. All right, anyway, that was awkward. I'm going to move on with the show here. We've had a lot of good comedians up tonight. We're going to switch things up now and go into some music. Starting with your next performer coming to stage, he's a very talented guy. I want you to clap it up for Mr. Dominic Delaney, everybody. Clap it up for him.
Yo, Mike.
Yeah.
This cord is purple.
It is.
That's dope.
Jesus.
So Elijah, you're from Boca?
Yes.
Did you go to school in Boca? Like, grow up in Boca? Boca sucks, so. I can agree with you there. And as far as your women getting free food, I had many experiences with Boca women growing up who used me for free food. To be honest, I was kind of hoping you were going to be terrible, because then it'd be easy to follow, but you're actually pretty good, and now I don't really know what to do.
What number is this?
How's everyone doing tonight? This is definitely you, not me. Mike Clark, everybody. There's a 9 bullet in there. If you guys have ever seen me play before, I'm typically very, very loud, and don't worry, that'll happen later. But this is gonna be a quiet song, because we have time for one, right? So, this is by a guy by the name of Frank Turner.
Seriousness. just needed somebody to wake me from my sleep. I could have been Napoleon, I could have been Beethoven, could have been anyone but uncomfortable me. So come on now, Josephine, show yourself to me. Come on now, Josephine, won't you give me what I need? I don't like to be needy, but needs must, and I can't stand being this person that I've been. I'm an impending car crash, you're the first one on the scene. I'm a defeated commander, I'm a half-deaf composer, I'm a strange name whispered in a dream. I could have been anyone I imagined I could be. I just needed somebody to wake me from my sleep. I could have been Napoleon, I could have been Beethoven, could have been anyone but uncomfortable me. So come on now, Josephine, show yourself to me. Oh, come on now, Josephine, let's pretend it's Halloween. You'll go as a car crash, I'll go as James Dean. I'm Napoleon Alba, and you're 100 days in 1815. Might make the pain linger more than it would if I was just a singer. But it's me and my guitar and my broken finger. Me and my guitar and my broken finger. The pain comes and goes, it hurts after shows, hurts in the morning and wherever I go. I don't like painkillers, right now that blows. The doctor said to leave it alone. And I said I can play my guitar with a broken finger. And I know that that choice might make the pain linger more than it would if I was just a singer. But it's me and my guitar and my broken finger. Me and my guitar and my broken finger. Hard as I can, but I'm pretty useless without my right hand. And if it looks like I'm giving you the bird, understand, it's got its own mind, yeah, it's got its own plan. I can play my guitar with a broken finger, and I know that that choice might make the pain linger more than it would if I was just a singer. But it's me and my guitar and my broken finger. Guitar and my broken finger. Well, my buddy Mitch got me the job. I'm honestly lucky that my finger's not gone. It was crushed by the weight of the world and mother-in-laws. I think that it's time to move on. Prescription for Jameson is all that I need. And if I had extra money, I'd get some fire ass weed. Well, thank you, my friends, for coming to see what my broken finger has done to me. What my broken finger has done to me.
This is probably one of the most beautiful pieces of music I've ever heard. It's by a guy by the name of Leonard Cohen. And there's, it's up in the air whether this song's about Joni Mitchell or Janis Joplin. So I'm gonna say, Joni Joplin.
I remember you well, the Chelsea Hotel. Talking so brave and so sweet. Giving me head on an unmade bed. Limousines wait in the street. Those were the reasons. And that was New York. We were running for the money and the flesh. Those were the love for the workers in song. Probably still is for those of them left. But you got away now, didn't you, babe? Just turn your back on the crowd. But you got away, I never once heard you say I need you. I don't need you. Oh, I need you. I don't need you. And all of that jive around. I remember you well from the Chelsea Hotel. And your heart was a legend. You told me again you preferred handsome men. For me, you would make an exception. Clenching your fists to the ones like us who are oppressed by these figures of beauty. You fixed yourself and said, never mind, we are ugly, but we have the music. You got away now, didn't you, babe? You just turned your back on the crowd. You got away, I never once heard you say I need you. I don't need you. Oh, I need you. I don't need you. And all of that time. Suggest that I loved you the best. I can't keep track of each fallen robin, but I remember you well from the Chelsea Hotel. But that's all, I don't think of you that often.
Hey guys, time permitting, I would like to do one more for you lovely folk.
Yeah.
This is one of my favorite songs I've ever written. I hope it's one of your favorite songs I've ever written. It's about how my lovely fiance down here, who's doing double duty as videographer and photographer, she keeps telling me I have a beer belly. That's what this song's about. Thank you.
and snow. And in this town, I'm barely known. I walk around, I'm gazing up. I'm lost again, I'm picking up. Barely it, but I'm still trying. I spend my time at parks and I get lonely. And I run around with my love, with my homies. And we'll take this town as soon as we get money. Oh yeah. Drunk again, I'm all alone. What is this place? Where is my home? The power's out, and I have no phone. Not breaking out, not shaking out. Is this the moment of love? I barely eat, but I'm still chugging. And I spend my time at parks and I get lonely. And I run around with my love, with my homies. And we'll take this town as soon as we get money. Oh, yeah.
Thank you guys very much. My name is Valentine, and this is show number 133.
Barely, but I'm still chubby, and I spend my time at bars, and I get lonely, and I run around with my love and with my homies, and we'll take this town as soon as we get lonely. Yeah, barely, but I'm still chubby.
One more time for Dominic, everybody. Clap it up for him. Yeah. Yeah, this is a beer belly. Like that. All right, folks. We're going to keep the music rolling. I like this show. It has good symmetry. It was comedy in the first half, music in the second half. We're going to keep it rolling now with your next performer coming to stage. I want you to clap it up for Sebastian Nato, everybody. Clap it up for him.
Valentine's Day, everybody. Some great acts going on. I'll try to do some love songs. We're close to it. It's good. So you can hear it, right? I can't tell. Yeah?
She motioned to me that she wanted to leave. Go somewhere warm where we'd be alone. 'Cause I do not know what's going on, but I'm guessing. Guessing it's an all-night thing. It's an all-night thing. If it's an all-night thing, nobody's gonna make it end. And if we don't think it's love, don't worry, I'll take a fan. Falling to the world for me. If it's an all-night thing, if it's an all-night thing, guessing it's an all-night thing. It's an all-night thing. It's an all-night thing. Rising on my troubled heart. Don't deny, you know you and I are the makings of what fate scrambled apart. My sweet Josephine, won't you come and marry me? I got every kind of love that you will ever need. Dying here on bended knee, sheets of rain, golden gray, run down the panes as I write your name. With just the weight of your silence now, it's clashing all around me while I scream it out loud. My sweet Josephine, won't you come and marry me? 'Cause I got every kind of love that you could ever need. Dying here on bended knee, like a raven in a cage, blood of my birth just won't wash away. Like a stitch together doll, feet to the flame as I fall on the blame for someone else's pain. For someone else's pain. Rivers of black ink flood, the tapestry of flesh and blood around my frame, a living shrine just for you if you be mine. The golden band upon your hand, leave this endless winter behind. My sweet Josephine, won't you come and marry me? 'Cause I got every kind of love that you'll ever need. Dying here on bended knees, dying here on bended knees, I'm dying here on bended knees, my Joseph.
laughing.
One more. Thank
you.
Wise men say only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love with you. Shall I stay? Would it be a sin if I can't help falling in love with you? Like a river flows surely to the sea, darling, so it goes. Some things are meant to be. Take my hand, take my whole life too, for I can't help falling in love with you. Like a river flows surely to the sea, darling, so it goes. Some things were meant to be. Take my hand, take my whole life too, for I can't help falling in love with you, for I can't help falling in love with you.
Time for Sebastian, everybody. Clap it up for him. All right, ladies and gents, we're in the home stretch for tonight's show. I've got three performers left for y'all this evening. Starting with your next guy coming to stage, I want you to clap it up for the singing stylings of Teddy, everybody. Clap it up for him.
L is for the way you look at me. O is for the only one I see. V is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you adore. And love is all that I can give to you. Love is more than just a game for two. Two in love can make it. Take my heart and please don't break it. Love was made for me and you. L is for the way you look at me. O is for the only one I see. V is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you adore and love. It's all that I can give to you. Love is more than just a game for two. Two in love can make it take my heart, and please don't break it. Love was made for me and you.
Thank you.
My name is Teddy. The next song I'm gonna sing is a song that I learned my freshman year of high school. I was a vocal performance major way back when. And we had to learn a song to like show emotion or whatever. So I learned it, I loved it, and I've been singing it ever since. So this is Until It Goes by Billy Joel. In every heart there is a room, a sanctuary safe and strong to heal the wounds of lovers past until a new one comes along. I spoke to you in cautious tones. You answered me with no pretense. And still I feel I've said too much. My silence is my self-defense. And every time my head rose, it seems I only felt the thorns. And so it goes, and so it goes, and so will you soon, I suppose. But if my silence made you leave, then it would be my worst mistake. So I will share this room with you, and you can have this heart to break. And this is why my eyes are closed. It's just as well for all I've seen. And so it goes, and so it goes, and so will you soon, I suppose. So I will choose to be with you. That's if the choice were mine to make. But you can make decisions too, and you can have this heart to break. And so it goes, and so it goes, and you're the only one who knows.
Thank you.
This next song I learned a couple years ago. It's by Ariana Grande. She's super popular. This is off her sophomore album. And it's called My Everything. it's a little, I don't know, it's, the song is called My Everything. I cried enough tears to see my own reflection in them, and then it was clear, I can't deny, I really miss it, to think that I was wrong. I guess you don't know what you got till it's gone. Pain is just a consequence of love. I'm saying sorry for the sake of us. He wasn't my everything till we were nothing. And it's taken me a lot to say. But now that you're gone, my heart is missing something. So it's time I'm pushing my pride away. Cause you are my everything. You are my everything. I know you're not far, but I still can't handle all the distance. You're traveling with my heart. I hope this is a temporary feeling, cause it's too much to bear without you, and I know sorry ain't the cure. If I cross your mind, just know I'm yours, cause what we got is worth fighting for. Cause you are my everything till we were nothing. And it's taken me a lot to say, but now that you're gone, my heart is missing something. So it's time I'm pushing my pride away. Cause you are my everything. You are my everything. Oh, yeah. You are my everything.
Thank you.
One more time for Teddy, everybody. Clap it up for him. Yay! All right, folks, coming to stage next, we've got Oliver Hanfman, everybody. Oliver, is he still here? Maybe he left? Oliver? Bueller? All right, well, I guess Oliver has departed, so that leaves us with our final performer for tonight. And forgive me if I say this wrong, it's kind of jumbled handwriting. We've got a singer, Veronique Petit-Homme. Yeah. All right, clap it up for her.
Song. That was awesome. All right, this song is by Corrine Ray Bailey. It's called Just Like the Star. I love this song, so I'm gonna share it with you. Mm-hmm. started my... Just like an angel of the beach, you have appeared to my life. Feel like I'll never be the same. Just like a song in my heart, just like the walls on my head. With anyone but you, we do it all the time. You got this look I can't describe. You make me feel like I'm alive when everything is awful. Just like an angel off the page, you have appeared to my life. Feel like I've never been the same. Just like a song in my heart, just like a poem on my head. Oh, I love to love you. I love it all again.
All right, one more time for Veronique, everybody. Clap it up for her. All right, ladies and gents, that concludes the Valentine's Day edition of the Brewhouse Open Mic. I hope you all had fun tonight. Remember, we do this each and every Thursday night, so if you had a good time tonight, keep coming back, and we'll see you all next time, everybody.